Hi everybody, today we're gonna see how to use the pages of Submasters. This is a very powerful tool that you should know to handle better your show. So we will start with clearing everything to start from scratch. So to do that, you just press 0 on your keypad and then you press the page button. You get a pop-up with propose to clear all fields. So you just press enter and it will clear all of your submasters. So now to fill a page with a content, that's quite easy. For example, we will start with loading channels in Submasters. So if you look at the previous tutorial, the part 1, it explains very well how to load with channels or groups and different things. So here we're gonna use some channels. So I press 1 and then I hold the channel key down and then I press all the assign buttons I need. So let's load this free submaster with 3 channels, and now I'm gonna record this page. So you, as usual, have a choice of just press record and hold, and together with the page key, which opens this pop-up, and which lets you give a name to your page. So let's call this one scroll, for example. And then you press record again or enter. And this is it. So now, if we go back to the zero page to clear everything, and then I've just to press my number of the page, so which is 4. I press 4 and then page, which loads directly the content into the submasters. Okay, so now let's clear it again and press 0 page, enter. And now we will load different channels in different submasters. So, for example, we'll use the 67 channel, and I load that into Submaster 4, 5, and 6, which are different channels. And I record that in a new page. So again, because now I have page 4, I can press 5, because I want to specify in which page I want to record. So I press 5 and record page. So now I'm sure to record into page 5 and I call this one Sinus. Enter. And I go back to page 0 pressing 0 page, enter. So everything is cleared now. So if I want to display all my pages, I can get a window where I can see my different pages. So if I press my page 4 with the scrollers, I get them back here. 0 page, enter to clear everything. And now if I press Sinus, I get my sinews here. So now you can see that if I press my page 4 to get my scroll back, this content has been added to the current page. Because if I go now into the edition of my page, as you can see here, my page 4 has been created by default as included only. What does it change? It means that this page will be added to the current content of my Submasters, since there is no conflict in these Submasters. So in this case, there was no conflict because one page contained Submaster 1 through 3 and the second page contained Submaster 4 through 6. So if I change that now into a clear all mode, what was the difference? Let's go back to zero page to start from scratch. I press scroll to get my scroll back, and I press now sinus. I got them because sinus is added to the current content. But if now I press again page 4, which is clear all, it will clear everything which is not in this page. So you have a kind of two different modes to work where one page can be added to the current content, or this page can be replacing the whole content of all the Submasters. So take care of that. You can decide at any time if a page will be added or replace the current content. The other function which is very nice with the page management is that you can also trigger the page change from the sequence. So let's take an example. We just record any step here to get an existing step in this sequence. And now you can decide at any time of your sequence to drag and drop and create a page link. And this page link will let you trigger a page load at any step you decide in your sequence. Such that, for example, if I go back to zero, I just clear my current page, zero, page, enter. And now I press the go in my sequence. And you can see that now it has loaded my sinus page into the Submasters. And that's pretty it for this tutorial. There will be another part talking about the different modes of the Submasters. See you later.